this tutorial, I am going to talk about how we can open a text file and read and write inside the text box. For this, I need a command button, and I use double click on this and name it callback function part 15, and the label is part 15 as well. And I am going to replace a text box, which is where you can put your file, and double click on it and remove the label and use the content of the text file. Okay, and I am going to move it up there, and I am going to replace the decoration indicating that they are together, and I am going to right click on part 15 and generate callback function, and in C file I am going to delete all those unnecessary events, and I am going to move this one under my callback functions. Control V. Okay, now I am going to declare a few variables of type char s of 100 elements, a file name. I can use a global variable here, define n or p max path name len. And I am going to use the P, and I am going to check if it was the same. Yes, max path name len, copy. Now I'm going to define it here, and it is V, and the file name is an integer m, and also an integer I. I am going to it is okay. Now I am going to use the same function from the previous tutorial, file pop up, and that one copy, and V, control V, and it is the file select pop up, and I am going to use any types of files and choose a file. Choose a file from a directory and one load button, and it is 00 because I want to surf in another directories, and I am going to put the result in file name. Then I am going to open the file with read only and open as it is and in ASCII format. Now I am going to I need the file pointed EFP, and fp equals open file, file name and reader from the file. And I am going to use a while loop, while fgets. String here, string or s, it's okay. If get s with 80 characters, efp is not equal null. Fget s is going to take a string with maximum length 80 and put it from the EFP here when we have opened the file, and we are going to read only, and if the get s get string from the file EFP with 80 characters and put it in s is not null, that means that it has it is something there. Then I am going to use the set control P, set control while, and this is panel handle, and I am going to delete the previews, and I am going to use the text box here, panel text box, and I am going to use S here. And control E, and then I am going to use again copy, and I am going to put a new line, character new line, or it must be string because it is a string component, and after that we are going to use fclose efp, and fclose efp, okay, it is all, and I am going to compile. Error appeared, 3-4 error, implicit declaration of a function open file. Implicit, why? Something wrong here, up here, and 488, it has this one, and this one is too much, and I'm going to compile it again. This one open file, it is the same as we have run it before, and the file name, it is all of them. Hi, it is okay. I am going to run. And I am going to select the part 15, and I am going to go back to my document. National instrument. I am going to use CVI and C sharp. I have a file, Keran. It is text file. I am going to load it. Now the context of the file, it's appear here, and hello, it is test, a new line. Hi, I want to know if it works. New line. This is the second line, new line. Therefore, I put something here, new line. This also is new line, but continues here. I put this row to check something. Okay, it works. Thanks. Now I am going quit. It worked. Now I am going to open the file again. Copy here, because I closed it, and I am going to open file again, and I am going to write read by each character. If I equal fget c, get a character, and what is it returning? It is a integer of EFP, if this one is not equal end of file, we are reading character by character. If f get c from the file, it is not end of file, it is not zero, then I am going to use sprintf s, and I am going to use format 02x in hexadecimal, and I am going to use I, and then I am going to set control val text box, copy V, and I am going to use S here, and then I am going to use the same here, copy here. Also, it takes each letter, each word, not word, each letter, and convert it to the hexadecimal and put it in R string, and it is going to fill our box. I am going to compile it. It's work. and I am going to select again part 15, and I am going to use the same yes, as you see it has converted the whole text, each letter converted to an hexadecimal value. Now I am going to use another file name, copy V. I am going to call it file name 2, and I am going to use F close here, and again open V, and you can use rewind EFP because it has read all those characters and put it in our text box, and the cursor is in the end of the file. I am going to use rewind EFP that we are going to the beginning of the text, and I am going to use fget s in s with 6 letters and EFP from EFP, and I am going to use 4 I equals 0 I less than 6 plus plus I. I'm going to concatenate string cat of I am going to declare a string with 80 long, and here I am going to use string, and I am going to concatenate string to the S from address of string of I, and I am going to, because I have read a string of 6 characters from EFP and put it in a string, then a string has 6 length and its index begin from 0 until 5, and it must be less than 6, and I am going to use the string cat s and a space, and after this I am going to use F close EFP, now I'm going to use message, which is the function we have defined in previous tutorial, and I am going to use this one. Now we are going to see what is happening here. 1973, hello. The first letter was the string was hello, and it's going to one step from, and it is that one, hello, and after that it's going to take the next, and it is lu, and thereafter is lo, and in the end of zero, because we decided that our letter is going to be six characters. Hello is five, and the end of that file is a space, and it's going to write only first hello, then steps in a next one, and use it all hello, olle, hello, and then it is LLO, and then LO, and then O. Okay, in this tutorial I show you how you can use those things, and how you can open a text file, and how you can read it, and how you can use each line, which is 80 character long, and how you can fill your text box. And in another way, you can use you can read each character, and in sprint f you can fill your string with hexadecimal, or you can use s2, and it is and it's going to write each letter in any row in your text box. And another way is that you read only the first six letters word. F get S, it gets string which has six character long, and you are going to write what is write those characters in your variable s, and you are going to print it out in a message box. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you in next tutorial.